knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
As we know, the five extant echinoderm classes are Crinoidea, Asteroidea, Ophiuroidea, Echinoidea, and Holothuroidea. Over the past two tutorials, we've covered the first three of these, so let's wrap things up with this phylum by covering the final two classes. First up is class Echinoidea, the sea urchins. Urchins generally have a compact body enclosed in an endoskeletal shell called a test, which is composed of tightly fitted dermal ossicles. Though they lack arms, their bodies do demonstrate a typical pentamerous body plan within their ambulacral areas, which uniquely among the echinoderms also expands up to the aboral side to an area close to the anus known as the periproct. Extant urchins are often classified as regular or irregular. Regular urchins, like the purple sea urchin, are called regular because they have a hemispherical shape, pentaradial symmetry, and medium to long spines. Sand dollars and heart urchins, meanwhile, are irregular because they have become secondarily bilateral. While regular urchins move using their tube feet, assisted by spines, irregular urchins move primarily using their short spines. Urchins generally have five converging teeth, which are self-sharpening, individually controlled by muscles, and held within a complex structure known as Aristotle's lantern, which is unique to the urchins. The oral area of a sea urchin is known as the peristome, and also includes five pairs of modified tube feet, and in many species, five pairs of gills. Food moves from the mouth into Aristotle's lantern, then into the esophagus, then into the small intestine and single cecum, which runs a full circle inside the test before joining the large intestine, rectum, and anus. Though sea urchins are largely omnivorous, their diets often consist mainly of algae and organic material that they graze with their teeth. Like most echinoderms, sea urchins have separate sexes, and reproduction is often indirect and external, where males and females simply shed gametes into the water column. Though some urchins brood their young, the majority of urchins have echinopluteus larvae that are planktonic for several months before beginning their radical metamorphosis into juvenile urchins. Sea urchins are perhaps best known for their anti-predator defenses, namely their long, sharp, and often hollow spines, which may be venomous in some species and can cause extreme pain or even breathing problems. Like most echinoderms, sea urchins play an important ecological role, and many genera, like the cactus urchins, are found only in the abyssal zone, where they are preyed upon by a great deal of predators, despite their tough armor and spines. Though there are fewer than 1,000 species of sea urchins, there are a great many orders in class Echinoidea. A few notable clades are as follows. Cydoroidea contains regular urchins often considered to be more primitive, many of which are long extinct, and extant versions have widely separated spines and simple plates in the test. Echinothurioidea and Diadematoidea have regular tests and hollow spines. Irregularia is often considered to be an infra class that contains the irregular heart urchins, sand dollars, and sea biscuits. Finally, Echinacea is a large and very diverse group that is found in seas all over the world, members of which are distinguished from other urchins by their rigid test, solid spines, and presence of gills. Remember, this is just a basic guideline of echinoderm classification, which may change over time. Lastly, we have class Holothuroidea, whose members are often commonly referred to as sea cucumbers. Like most echinoderms, these are found in oceans worldwide. They differ from other echinoderms in that they are elongated and bear greatly reduced ossicles, meaning most species are essentially soft-bodied and have secondarily lost their ossified endoskeleton. There are less than 2,000 described sea cucumber species, many of which play an important ecosystem role in marine habitats, where they cycle nutrients and are decomposers that break down dead and decaying material. Sea cucumbers have spacious coelomic cavities that are fluid-filled and serve as a hydrostatic skeleton. Their digestive system is comprised of a mouth, which passes food into the pharynx that is typically surrounded by a ring of calcareous plates, often the only calcified or bony part on their bodies. From here, food is passed into the esophagus and stomach, followed by the intestine, which is long and coiled and often loops through the body three times before terminating at the cloacal chamber, which also serves a function in reproduction, excretion, and respiration. Sea cucumbers exchange gases and release wastes using branching respiratory trees, which stem out from the cloaca and form highly branched tubes inside the body. Many sea cucumbers are noted for their unique defense mechanism where they eviscerate themselves through muscular contractions that spew out respiratory and/or digestive organs coated in a sticky mucus and detach from the body. These organs then later regenerate. Sea cucumbers are noted from their symbiosis with other organisms. There are many species, like pearlfish, that live within the sea cucumber cloaca. There are parasitic mollusks that dig into the fleshy body of sea pigs. And crustaceans like the cleaner shrimp live and feed on the sea cucumber dorsal surface. In most sea cucumbers, sexes are separate, and they reproduce sexually by releasing sperm and ova into the water column. However, some species do brood eggs, and others, like the red-chested sea cucumber, fertilize their eggs internally. In most species, the egg develops into a tiny free-swimming auricularia larva that metamorphosizes into the barrel-shaped doleolaria, which becomes a pentacularia, which in turn becomes a sexually immature juvenile that then matures into an adult. The exact number of sea cucumber orders is a bit contested, but there are typically 7 orders listed. Members of order Apodida lack tube feet and are elongated in form. Their shapes are often adapted for burrowing within the sediment, and their mouth is surrounded by tentacles. Members of order Dendrochirotida are filter feeders with 10 to 30 branching tentacles, which are connected to retractor and introvert muscles. Some species attach themselves to the hard substrate, while others burrow into soft sediment. Order Elasopodida contains species with numerous appendages, leaf-like tentacles, and the only known echinoderms that are pelagic rather than benthic, meaning that some species, like the headless chicken monster, actually spend most of their lives swimming the water column. They also include the now well-known sea pig, as well as a great number of abyssal species. The final 4 orders, Holothuroidea, Mulpadida, Persiculida, and Synalactida, all have the characteristic sea cucumber shape and were at various times considered to be part of the polyphyletic and obsolete order Aspidochiratida, with the exception of Mulpadida, members of which have a narrowed hind body and distinct tail. And with that, we've summarized the diversity of the echinoderms, which means we have only one phylum to go, but we are nowhere near finished with our task of exploring the diversity of animal life on our planet. Our last phylum, Chordata, is the phylum to which you and I belong. Let's move forward and begin to learn all about chordates.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.